The Philippine president's sister, Senator Imee Marcos, urges him to block attempts by House lawmakers to amend the Constitution through a signature campaign. Philippine Catholic bishops suspect people have been deceived into signing a supposed people's initiative. This report from R.G. Cruz.
Philippine Senator Imee Marcos is calling on President Marcos to stop the People's Initiative, which senators described as flawed and divisive. The presidential sister insists she will not allow the family name to be ruined again as charter change efforts spark disputes.
This is no mere family squabble. We're talking about the Republic and the Constitution and the heart and soul of democracy here in our country. Kung sino man ang nagsimula niyan, kamag-anak ko man o hindi, talagang tututulan ko. As I've said many times, we are the most fortunate family on earth. With the grace and blessing of a second chance.
This was echoed by Senator J.B. Ejercito, who believes democracy is at stake if the People's Initiative pushes through.
Hindi lang po Senado bilang institusyon ang nakasalalay po rito. It's our whole democratic institution ang at stake.
Senate employees also joined the chorus opposing the initiative, calling it ill-timed. They urged Congress to shift their focus on improving the welfare of workers.
Hindi po ito napapanahon. Pagkos nananawagan po kami na ipasa ang mga batas na nagtataas ng sahod ng mga empleyado, hindi lang sa pamahalaan, ngayon din sa private sector, ipasa ang 33,000 national minimum wage law, ensure ang job security, ang food security, dahil yan po ang mga issues na dapat nating pag-usapan sa ngayon.
For Catholic Bishops Conference of the Philippines President Bishop Pablo Virgilio David, he believes some signatories supporting charter change did not have full knowledge or understanding of what the signature forms represent. He also says the process was deceptive, adding that this initiative did not emanate from the people. David also urges people to keep watch over other efforts to revise the charter. He hopes there will be genuine discussions about the Constitution and issues facing the nation. The Commission on Elections backs the CVCP's call even as some signatures have been withdrawn in Antique.
Kung napansin po ninyo noong mga nakaraang linggo, araw, sinasabi natin, pag tayo ipipirma, alamin natin ano ang implikasyon nito sa ating buhay, ano ba yung pinapipirmahan sa atin, yan po ay ordinaryo sa ating pang-araw-araw na pamumuhay upang hindi tayo nagugulat, hindi tayo nabibigla, at the same time, hindi tayo nalilinlang.
House leaders say they will abide by the orders of the Commission on Elections and the Supreme Court amid challenges to the People's Initiative.
Whatever it is, ang statement niya ni Speaker kahapon pa, we will abide. Pati yung sinasabi earlier na report na dadaling sa Supreme Court ng Senate, itong PI na ito. Kung ano man na decision ng Supreme Court, then sabi niya ni Speaker, we will follow that.
Tulfo maintains the House doesn't want to quarrel with the Senate, saying they were instructed to concentrate on work.
What the House wants is we'll just avoid na a clash with the Senate. Kasi kumbaga sa kuan, boss, parang kaming pamilya rin, magkakapatid . Why do we fight with our brothers, di po ba? Instead of just focus on our work, which we still have a lot of work to do.
House Secretary General Reginald Velasco hopes tensions between the two chambers will simmer down following the Senate's decision to start its work on a charter change. Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, meantime, sees the conflict de-escalating after the poll body halted all proceedings involving the People's Initiative.
Umupuan na kasi nga nag-issue na ang COMELEC, pinahinto na yung pagtanggap nito mga People's Initiative, yung mga pirma. Kaya humuhupa na yung tension. At maganda yun kasi ang importante ngayon, magtrabaho na. Talagang linabanan namin yung People's Initiative dahil pag babasahin mabuting People's Initiative, walang limitation yun. Pwedeng economic, pwede rin political.
Yun
at pag ang political, anything goes na yan. At pwede nang habaan in term limits.
Senator Marcos insists they are not against changes to the Constitution if the process was more transparent.
The Senate is not against Chacha. It is not against the economic provisions amendments. It is not against even the People's Initiative. Huwag lang ganito. Huwag naman sa pamamaraan na ganito. It is misleading, deceiving. Huwag naman ganito. Huwag naman tinatanga yung tao. Binobobo tayo.
RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.